The museum has an extraordinary history. The museum itself actually began after World War II. It was established as an after-school program for children by 16 women teachers here in the community who believed that kids needed somewhere to go after they got out of school. And from there began a school, which in turn became the museum school, which in turn became the museum. So from that beginning, the museum slowly grew. And in the early 1980s, in 1983, was when the museum added the Omni Theater. It really complemented the museum experience.
Well, I feel a huge connection to the museum because I came here as a kid and I feel like I've grown up with the museum. The one thing that people say about the Science and History Museum is just how much it's grown, and it really is a connector of the community.
When I stepped in as the interim leader of the museum, that is when I really came to learn about the Omni Theater. Unfortunately, at that moment in time, we had shuttered the theater back when we had closed the museum for the pandemic. And the theater at that point was already in a bit of disrepair, and it became too difficult to reopen the theater. In the meantime, the staff that was here had already begun working on a plan to do a renovation of the theater. And a renovation was not only a physical renovation of the space, but it was also to replace the IMAX, the old IMAX technology, to a digital screen, a digital dome. And so as I learned about all this, I realized how important it was to get this renovation accomplished and get our Omni Theater back open again. At the same time, I also appreciated how exciting it would be to be the first museum in the country, if not the world, to actually have this digital dome for the new Omni. So that is what inspired myself and the staff here to really work hard to raise the funds that we need to embark on this renovation.
I think it's really unexpected to have this right here in Fort Worth and to be one of the first cities to have this experience. And I think that's one of the things that Fort Worth always does, is it really puts itself out there and looks for these unique experiences.
The Omni itself had opened in 1983 with what was then state-of-the-art, you know, IMAX technology. Now, state-of-the-art was 70 millimeter film footage in very, very large reels, you know, through a projection system onto this screen that was a dome. The IMAX company actually did modernize their technology where they went to digital projection and things like that. But here, for whatever reason, it just had not been a priority. However, in an ironic sort of way, that is what gave us this opportunity. We were able to actually do this leap ahead to a digital dome where the screen that you're looking at is actually composed of LED modules that are projecting the image the same way that when you're at home watching your flat screen television, the same way that that technology works. We saw that as just, you know, so exciting to put Fort Worth once again in the forefront of this theater technology for the museum. The COSM technology uses these 10 inch by 10 inch LED modules. Given the size of our dome, it requires 12,000 modules, 12,000 LED modules.
The sound is unbelievable, and it's much like a mesh overlay, and then the speakers are behind it. And so you get that dimensional sound, and it's beyond surround sound.
Whatever it is that you're looking at on the screen, you will feel like you are there. And in my opinion, that really is the definition of immersive.
The dome is a real 360 experience, and there's just an engagement that's unlike anything I've experienced. The possibilities for this new COSM Theater in Fort Worth are limitless. I think there's so many things we can do with its virtual components, whether that's a conference or that's a product launch. I think there's so many things that we could do to have music. I think there's so many different things, and we're only seeing the beginning potential of what this could be and what is really unexpected about it.
The museum and the museum staff is tremendously excited about bringing the Omni online. We're going from 100% analog to 100% digital. When you go to 100% digital, the sky's the limit. Now you can do everything and anything. And that includes the ability for the museum to have a small staff here that can actually produce content that can go up on the screen.
People are really excited for the renovation. There's a lot of buzz with Cosm and what is this. It's mind-blowing. The capabilities are going to be amazing. There's so many possibilities the Dome will have. I just think that it's up to our imagination of what we want to do, and it has so much potential. It's really incredible.
Our hope here at the museum is that the reaction of our guests who come to the new Omni and sit in that theater and watch a show is wow. In one simple word, wow.